Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and today I'm going to show you guys how to set up Facebook lead ads inside of Gohighlevel in just 5 easy steps. And if you stay till the end, I'll show you how to test it so that you know it's working properly. So let's get started. Step 1, we're going to set up our Facebook integrations first. So go ahead and click on settings, and we're inside the sub account. Go to integrations and find the Facebook logo. I'm going to go ahead and remove my connection so I can show you how it works. So you're going to want to click on connect, and Facebook may ask you on the screen to select a page that you want to connect and authorize Hi-Level to. In this case, it's the easiest, most convenient option to select all, because in the future, if you ever want to connect to another Facebook page with Hi-Level again, you're gonna have a lot more problems if you don't do this. So I always recommend just click select all, and that's not the actual page that's gonna be connected, it's just the authorization. Go ahead and click the page that you wanna use and click on connect Facebook and Instagram. That was easy. Step 2, we're gonna set up a Facebook leads ad. Disclaimer, this is not a video on how to set up a leads ad, but you do need to make sure that it is a Facebook leads ad so that you can get the fields into Hi-Level from Facebook. So when you create your ad, make sure that it is in fact a leads ad. After you create your ad, do your copy, do your images, everything like that, and create a lead form where it will say a form is required for this ad. Once you're done with that, then we're going to map these fields inside of Hi-Level. So go ahead and pause, set this up, and come back to the video. Step 3, we're going to do our Facebook form mapping on Hi-Level. So go ahead and click on Facebook form fields mapping. Now this is under settings and integrations. I'm still here. This is going to pull in all of your Facebook form fields from Facebook. So go ahead and click on map fields, and you'll see all of your fields here. You'll also be able to map custom fields inside of Hi-Level as well. So it would look something like this. You would have multiple form fields, and you would actually be able to select any of these fields that you desire. Now, I want you guys to keep in mind too, this is something that has happened a lot to me in the past and has happened to others. A lot of people get tripped up with this. If for any reason your Facebook account gets compromised, locked out, you change your password, you may have to redo your integration. I know they've made a lot of improvements, but just a disclaimer to keep an eye on it and make sure that your leads are still coming in as they are supposed to, okay? Now, step 4, the good stuff, we are going to set up the workflow. So we're going to go into automations and workflows. We're going to create a new workflow from scratch. And here we're going to pull all of our leads in and then automatically contact them to let them know we got their info and start immediately sending them texts, emails, and get them really engaged with our brand. So the first component of this is the trigger. And you can think of this like something that's going to fire off the workflow, okay? So there's two components, the trigger that fires off the workflow, and then the actions that take place after the trigger is fired. So we're gonna start typing face, and here you can see Facebook lead form submitted. Now this is really important because if you have multiple Facebook lead forms, you could end up in some hot water if you don't select which one that you want to map. So we're going to say add a filter in the form, and then we're going to do lead ad. Now make sure that that's the right one, okay? You'll know because you just set it up in the business manager. And then our actions, we can do anything we want here. The possibilities are endless. We can text our lead, we can email our lead, we can add tags, we can add them to a pipeline. So I'm gonna do all that stuff with you right now. The first thing I like to do is add a contact tag because you know what? I don't trust anything anymore, right? I was in IT for like 20 years, and I always make sure CYA when I'm doing anything in technology. So I wanna know that my lead came from Facebook, so I'm gonna add a tag FB here. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to add an opportunity card because I want to see them on my pipeline. So I'm just going to pick a pipeline here. I'm going to put it in the new lead pipeline. And then for opportunity name, we can just say full name, opportunity source. Here's a great place to put Facebook. Or you can map a custom value. And then lead value, you know your lead value, hopefully. So just you can put that in there. It's optional. And then I usually don't use these two because it just makes a mess out of things. okay, now we're going to communicate with our lead. So we're going to send them an SMS and we're going to say, hey, first name, thanks for this is, and then we're going to say whatever your name is because we want to tell them like who we are. I'm going to say owner, first name with, and then you can also map like the location name, but I'm just going to type it for now. And then thanks for opting in for our free snowshoes. We will be calling you soon from this number to verify your information to claim your offer. Okay. Now, obviously I'm not selling free snowshoes, but put whatever you need to put there. I always like to give them a heads up. I'm going to call them from that number because then they'll hopefully unblock the number. Then we can also email our lead. So we're going to send them an email and we can say something very similar. And we're sending these right away. Okay. Now, if you want to add a delay, you can. That's called a wait step. So if I want to wait for like 5 minutes to send them an email, I can. Don't recommend waiting though, because speed to lead is really, really, really important, especially with like cold leads. Okay, so I always recommend like publish, save, and then putting yourself through it to make sure it looks right. So definitely do a test workflow, put yourself through here, and you can rename it like Facebook, right? But the most important part of this is actually testing it with Facebook for real. And no, I don't mean actually running the ad, spending money, then putting in your own information. You don't have to do any of that stuff. So you can actually use the lead ad testing tool over on Facebook. This is step 5. Make sure you please test your integrations that they're working properly. So it's developers.facebook.com/tools/leads-ads-testing. Here you can select your Facebook page, your lead form, and you can click on create lead. So, so cool. I like to do preview form just to see what it looks like. Here you can put in your email and then your phone number and click on next, click on submit. And now I know that my test lead has been sent. You can only do one of these at a time though. So if you want to do it again, you have to delete the previous one. Okay, then you'll see what happens. This is the call to action. So you can actually test all that stuff. So if I go in here and I do the right one, then I'll be able to go in here and see on my logs if this actually worked or not, right? So I may need to actually like refresh this. So if you don't see it in here, you might need to wait a little bit. You'll also be able to see like a one where the number of contacts like are going through currently. If you don't see it, it means something went wrong with your integration or you don't have it set up properly. So you'll be able to validate if it's set up correctly before you start spending money on Facebook ads. So this was a 5-step guide on how to set up Facebook lead ads and integrate them with Gohighlevel and start sending messages to your leads right away. I hope this helped you, and don't forget to like and subscribe so don't miss any future videos from me, as well as get a link to a free trial and bonuses in the description below. I'll see you next time.